to you, our beautiful people. Thank you for tuning into another episode of TSL on the go. July is a month that has been packed with so much drama, and today we are bringing the hottest gist from this week to your screen. I'm Wana Danna,
and I'm Favour of Yenloba.
See you after the break. Welcome back. Now, like I said earlier, July is a month that has been packed with so much drama. An old adage says that soup is sweetest when cooked at home. But I doubt the presidency agrees with us, because Femi Adesina, the special advisor to the president on media and publicity, has come out to say that the presidential clinic has been turned to a mere medical center. And that is why our president has to always go to the UK for medical checkup. Favour. That soup that they're cooking in the UK, is it not good enough for Nigerians too?
It baffles me, Adanna, because it's such a lame excuse for the presidential aides to give to defend the president. Why would you say the medical centers, Adanna, it's so uncomfortable.
I know you
now, if somebody is sick and you have a medical history, if he would have transferred the medical history to doctors in Nigeria by consent. So I don't know, I don't understand why he would still be going for medical checkups.
Yeah, and he went on to say that it is because he has over 40 years relationship with this, you know, medical centers, in medical practitioners in the UK. But can't you incorporate something similar to our health centers? Because, you know, a lot of things are, sorry to say, a lot of things are lacking in our health centers. Mm. If you go there, so many facilities are not in place.
Yeah.
And is it because of the poor state, or is he just trying to make up excuses? Because
yeah, it goes to show that he does not have faith in our medical system. He does not.
Okay, moving on. CBN has banned BDCs, that is Bureau de Change, saying that the reason for this ban is because of illicit practices by the traders. Favour, I want to know how much dollars you have in your wallet right now.
Know,
and how are you going to be able to change it?
I don't have at all. Now, this ban has its negative and positive effects, you know. But I think it's a welcome idea if they can actually keep up to it. Because even in other countries, in Western countries, they have BDCs, but it's highly regulated, which is what they would have done, you know, to regulate it.
Yeah, I think they're trying to regulate it because he said now people are going to be going to the commercial banks for the transactions. But do you think the commercial banks can keep up, you know, genuinely without any mugu-mugu kind of play?
I doubt, Adanna, because the banks will end up, they will hoard it and in the end still sell it to the BDCs. Okay. Which will cause inflation.
We really, really hope for the best in the banking sector. Moving on, let's dive to education. They say knowledge is power. Yes, but I'm wondering whether the power of knowledge has been transferred to the cane. Because a very prestigious federal university in Nigeria, Nnamdi Azikiwe University, a male lecturer has been accused of physically brutalizing a female student with a cane because she failed to appear in the department on an Ankara attire. I'll ask my question again to you, Favour. Has the power of education been transferred to the cane?
I don't know. When I saw this news, I went to check if it was actually UNIZIC University or a primary and secondary school. Because I don't understand why a lecturer would do that to even a female student. That's domestic violence. So I think the Senate, the school panel should call the lecturer to order. The SUG ESCOs, they should make sure this doesn't slide, else it become a norm.
Yeah, I totally agree with you. I feel the only time when dress code should come into play is when someone is indecently dressed. But I saw what she was putting on. She was putting on a blouse and her body was well covered. So I don't see why you should brutalize a student because she did not appear on Ankara. Okay, under entertainment, all does not seem to be rosy in the celebrity paradise, as an innocent post made by former BBN contestant Uriel has faced a lot of criticism. Let me go on and explain the post. Uriel posted a picture of a guy and she said the guy was her ex. Few minutes later, she came back to say that people have gone into his DM to shoot their shots, people that even have friends, and people have been going on to say, don't let Uriel know about it. Another celebrity, Nkechi Blessing, came out to say that Uriel hasn't even seen the half of it, that her husband goes through the same thing every day, and most of her friends are part of people that go to shoot their shots as the husband. Favour, I thought that was where the drama was going to end, but it turns out that the drama still has a lot going on.
Yeah.
As estranged wife of footballer Judy Harlow came out to say that Uriel is a hypocrite, as she has illicit affairs with married men too. And she should not go on to say that people are coming to blast her when she does things to other people's husbands.
Adanna, see, I will not dwell too much on this issue because Uriel has come out to say again now that if she was dating an ex-footballer, or footballer rather, that she would not be driving the car that she will be, that she's driving a Honda Custom. Living, you know, the baby girl life.
Yeah.
But then I would not want to be the judge.
Okay.
Because I don't know what's actually happening. But I will say married men, stick to your wife. Married wives, stick to your husband. And singles, pray for your own husband.
Hallelujah.
Pray for your
home. Thank you so much for taking out your time to watch. And thank you so much for always liking and commenting on our videos. If you have not subscribed, please hit the subscribe button down below. Do also follow us on all our social media platforms at TSL Nigeria TV on Instagram and on Facebook. Also, make sure you invite your friends to like and comment on our videos. We're going to be back next week on TSL On The Go with so much juicy content from next week. See you next week. I'm Wana Adana.
I'm Favour Ovianloba.
Have a great weekend.
Stay connected to TSL Nigeria and get updates on the go all day, every day. Subscribe to our YouTube channel on TSL Nigeria Space TV and join our online family.